Hey everyone, welcome to the weekly reset in Destiny. This week's Nightfall is the Will of Crota, and after last week's Breeze of the Nightfall, we get some of the absolute worst for this one. The modifiers are Brawler, Grounded, Chaff, and Match Game. Brawler is the only good thing here, and you don't want to get close enough to anything to hit it, so it's a wasted modifier. The rest is pretty terrible. The Will of Crota and Omnigul are already a tedious and miserable combination for a Nightfall, and with these modifiers, it's just no fun. You have nothing here that is helping you, and with the amount of adds and the time you'll need to clear them, you're not going to have a good time doing this solo. I wasn't able to complete this one in time for the Sunrise Bounty, but I'm not too upset by that. I'm on the Warlock again this week because Omnigul, man. No way am I going in there without a backup light. In the opening section, you have Ogres and Wizards with Solar Shields, then Fallen Captains with Void Shields, so bring weapons to match accordingly. It's a grind, but you can play it safe from the entrance and not have to venture out too far if you don't want to. In the next section, it's Hive again, along with some Fallen. Again, you'll come up against Solar Shields on the Wizards and Void on the Captains. This too is a long grind, ducking back into the room to recover while taking shots or firing rockets where you can. Enemies will continue to spawn from the Tomb Ship, so you'll be here a while. On the final approach to Omnigul, you guessed it, more Hive and more Fallen, with the same shields you faced in the first two encounters. More grind, more time. And then there's Omnigul. As most of you know, the entrance room is closed off to the boss fight, so you have to do everything in the same room with her. Waves of enemies spawn in periodically, as well as when you do a certain amount of damage to her. Lots of exploding Thrall and Boomer Knights, so good luck. In my run, I easily spent 40 minutes on this fight alone, taking it slow and letting my super refill in case I died. And I did plenty of that. This is only part of the fight. To speed things up for you guys, I actually switched to the Dragon's Breath for the second half, and that seemed to work the best in keeping damage on her constant to avoid her regaining an overshield. When things got too hairy, I retreated to underneath the walkway to rebuild a super or use a heavy ammo sink. I rinsed and repeated this until the final damage phase, then dealt with all the adds that spawned in with that. Once they were gone, I waited for my self-res again, then moved in for the final damage round, which you'll see at the end. Again, it got a little dicey once the knights caught up to me, but I managed to somehow get this one done, no thanks at all to the modifiers. So that is it for me. Good luck on your own Nightfall run and blue swirly flames, and I'll see you around, Guardians.
Back. remind me of, well, Ikora in the Crucible days.
That was a lifetime ago.
I'm sure Shax hasn't forgotten. He still has trouble sitting. The Cosmodrome is turning into a breeding ground for Hive and Siva. It's like one big, disgusting petri dish. that you're all warmed up, let's find Omnigul. Omnigul is back for a reason, and it's not just a yell, though she does seem fond of that. Finish her before it's too late.
Thank you.
There are no further traces of Hive energy.
Well, if she comes back, so will we. Look at us. Omnigul's neutralized and Eris didn't have to lift a finger.